Good morning, dear students. I am Sarvama, faculty of mathematics. Dear students, today we are going to learn about the new concept data handling. Do you know the meaning of data handling? Yes, dear students. What's the meaning of data handling? Data means any information. Data handling means sorting information according to what is available. Again, data means any information. Data handling means sorting information according to what is available. Okay. Then, data collection means the process of preparing and collecting data. Then, data handling means grouping object and counting the object in each group. Okay, dear students, let's look at the picture. Observe the poster. Appu has this poster of different fishes. There are four kinds of fishes here. One is a blue, other one is a red, and the third one is a yellow, and the fourth one is red and white. Dear students, Appu has this poster of different fishes. Look at in the next, you just how many different kinds of fishes are there? Count and write in the box. There are four different kinds of fishes. So firstly, blue, red and white, yellow and then saffron. Okay. Let's count. How many fishes are there? Blue color fishes. Let us count the blue color fishes. How many are there? Only one. And the red and white color fishes are 4, and the yellow color fishes 3, and the saffron color fishes are 2. Let's write the numbers in this. So here, dear students, blue color fishes, number of blue color fishes are how many? Is only 1. So you write here number 1. And then red and white color fishes are 4. How many is? There are 4. And the yellow color fishes are only 3. And the saffron color fishes are? There are 2 fishes. So number of blue color fish 1. Number of red and white color fishes 4. Number of yellow color fishes 3. Number of saffron color fishes 2. So look at, dear students, here which colored fishes are more in the number in the given poster. As you know, here the blue color fishes is 1 and the red and white color fishes are 4, yellow color fishes are 3 and then saffron color fishes are only 2. So look at which colored fishes are more in the number in the given poster. Color them. So, which color fishes has more in the number? Yes, exactly. This one is a more. That is white and red. So, which is here? First one or second one? Yes, the second one, fish. So, now you color the fish. What is red and white? Okay. Then, which colored fishes are least in the number? The given poster, color them. So, which color fishes is least in the number? So, which is first one or second one? Yes, the blue color fishes. Look at, it is the total number of fishes. What is? Only 1. So, now you color this one fish. So, what is the color? Blue. Here, this color is red and white. Okay. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Okay, dear students, let us come activity 2. Here, Ananya has invited all of her friend her birthday. Shall we go to her birthday? Her house to celebrate her birthday. So, firstly, who is her friends? Suma, Rashmi, Peter, Krishna and Anu went to Ananya's house. Vishudharan gave gift. So here Ananya celebrate her birthday. So that's why he invited all her friends to her house. So look at firstly, Ananya, oh, very surprising, I have got of many gift. Suma, Ananya, you have got dolls, crayons, pencil box, chocolates, pens, water bottle and many more gift. So let us look at Ananya's received the gift from her friends. So firstly, what is crayons, chocolates, dolls, water bottles, pencil box and then pens. So look at dear students, firstly let us count the total gift of received from her friends. So firstly, number of dolls. Look at number of dolls, how many is 2. And then number of crayons, number of dolls 2, number of crayons how many is 10. And then number of chocolates 4, number of pencil box 1, number of pen 3, number of water bottle 2. So Ananya received birthday gift from her friends. So which is number of dolls 2, number of crayons 10, number of chocolates 4, number of pencil box 1, number of pen 3, number of water bottles 2. Let us, dear students, here collection of data and represent the datas in systematically, that is called as table. Okay, look at dear students, firstly here serial number 1, gift and then number. So firstly what I say, what is collection of datas and representing in systematically, it is called as table. This is, look at, this is a table. Look at, this is a table, isn't it? Yes. So number of gift and then how many are there. So let us, number of dolls, as you know, 2. Number of crayons 10. Number of chocolates 4. Number of water bottles 2. Number of pencil box 1. Number of pens 3. The total gift how many is 22. So look at dear students, let's count the total number of gift here. 10. 10 plus 3 13. 13 plus 2 15. 15 plus 2 17. 17 plus 3 20. Then what is one pencil box 22. So total number of gift received from her friends not 22. So let us go to the next one example. What is activity 3? Sushila and her mother go to the fruit shop. They buy apples, pomegranate, banana and then oranges. Out of curiosity, Sushila wanted to count each type of fruits and list them. You can help her. Yes. Firstly, how many are there apples? Let us, there are 4 kinds of fruits. So firstly, number of apples, number of banana, number of pomegranate, number of orange. So firstly count, dear students, number of apples. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Number of apples 8. Let's count to the banana. Number of bananas 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of banana 4. And then number of orange 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then number of pomegranate only 2. Here 1 and then 2. Isn't it? Yes. Dear students, let's write in the table how many are there. How many are there? Look at the table. As I told you, it is collect the daughters and representing in systematically, represent the daughters in systematically. It is called as table, isn't it? Yes. So firstly, number of apples. How many apples are there? There are 8 apples. And then number of pomegranate. How many pomegranate are there? There are 6 pomegranate. Number of bananas, you know very well, 4. Number of oranges, only 2. So number of apples, 8. Number of pomegranate, 6. Number of bananas, 4. Number of oranges, 2. Isn't it? Yes. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Activity 4. Use each of the articles given below and fill the bucket with the water. Count the numbers of times you use each articles and write the numbers. It's your homework. Okay. Do it in at your home. So it is the articles and the quantity of water required to fill the bucket. So here there are a given quantity of water required to fill the bucket. Here in the article, mug, water bottle and then vessel. So look at what is the question. Use each of the articles given below and fill the bucket with water. Count the numbers of times you use each articles and write the numbers. How many mugs you fill the bucket, how many water bottles you fill the what is bucket, and then how many vessels to fulfill the bucket. Just you write the numbers. How many times you use each articles, then you write here. Okay. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Look at dear students, activity 5. Measure the breadth of your classroom with a hand span, cubit and foot, write them. So here dear students, as you know, the non-standard unit measurements, cubit, hand span, foot span, fathom and then footstep, isn't it? Yes, units of measurement breadth of the classroom. So firstly, hand span, cubit and the foot span. What is the things here? You just find out the length of your classroom. Okay. What is find out the breadth of the in your home. That means hall. That is how many hand span, how many cubits and then how many feet. Do it at your home. So dear students, activity 6. Aruna has a chart of various kinds of colored flowers. You can help her to sort out the flowers according to the tables given. As I told you, any information, what is collection of data and representing in systematically, that is called as table. So here Aruna has a chart of various kinds of colored flowers. You can help her to sort out of them according to their table. So firstly, here there are so many flowers. You know what is the first one? Hibiscus, rose, sunflower and then lotus. There are 4 kinds of flowers here. One is a hibiscus and then rose and then lotus and then sunflowers. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Now you make a tables. So given the poster. So firstly, number of roses and then number of sunflowers, number of hibiscus and then number of lotus. Let's count the flowers here in the given picture. Firstly, number of roses. So here dear students, number of roses are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many roses are there? There are 9 roses. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Number of sunflowers. So number of sunflowers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number of sunflowers 5. And then number of hibiscus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Number of hibiscus 12. And then number of lotus are there. How many lotus are there? There are, look at, 1, 2, there are only 2 lotus. How many is? There are 2 lotus. Totally, how many is are there? So, 12 plus 5. Then, look at dear students. Yes. Number of roses 9. Number of sunflowers 5. Number of hibiscus 12. Number of lotus 2. So here now you write the total numbers of flowers. Firstly, so total number of, here write the numbers in the given table. So, dear students, let's write the total number of flowers. You know very well, number of roses are only 9, number of sunflowers 5, number of hibiscus 12, number of lotus 2. Total number of flowers 28. So number of roses 1, number of sunflowers 5, number of hibiscus 12, number of lotus 2. Isn't it? Yes, the total number of flowers here, what is? 28. So let's move the next one. Here some questions are there related to above, what is the poster. Look at dear student, answer the following questions. Which flowers is maximum in the number? So you know very well, which flowers is maximum in the numbers? So firstly, number of roses 12, number of sunflowers 2, number of hibiscus 9, number of lotus 5. Dear students, so which flowers is maximum in the number? So look at the table, which flowers is the maximum in the number? What is? That is a rose flower. Then total number of rose flowers 12. So you write here rose, R-O-S-E. Rose. You write here R-O-S-E. Rose. Let's go to the next one example. Which flowers is minimum in the number? So which flowers is minimum in the number? Yes, that is a, what is? Lotus. So now you write lotus spelling L-O-T-U-S. Lotus. Isn't it? Yes. When you compare the numbers of rose with the sunflowers, compare the numbers of roses with the sunflower, which flowers is more in the number? Which flowers is more in the number? That is rose. R O S E, rose. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Look at dear students. Activity 7. Observe the picture. Here balls of various sizes are kept. List them according to their size. So firstly, first one, football, cricket ball, then hockey ball. How many are there and write down the numbers. Let us count the balls. So look at firstly football. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The total number of football, what is 7. Then the next one, how many cricket balls are there? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many are there? Cricket balls? 10. And then, how many hockey balls are there? So, the small size balls are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How many are there? There are 12. Now you write one by one. So, firstly, how many is the number of footballs are 7, number of cricket balls 10, number of small size balls 12. So, look at dear students. Total number of balloons are, what is, 29. Then, so which type of balls is more in the number? Put a right mark. So which is more in the number? The 7 or 10 or 12? Yes. This type of ball is more in the number. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Which type of balls is fewer in the number? Put a right mark. Which balls is? So, here it is a this one ball. Dear students, activity 8. Read the information given the chart and answer the following questions. So, girls and then boys and then total. Here, favorite activities of students of class in the given below. So, girls in music, there are 12. And then, girls in dance, 20. And then, reading, 9. Art and craft, 34. And the games, 16. Come to the boys column. In music, 6. In dance, 8. In reading, 11. In art and craft, 25. In games 40. Total 12 plus 6 is 18 and the in dance 20 plus 8 28 and reading 9 plus 11 20 and art and craft 34 plus 25 59 and the games 16 plus 40 is equal to 56. Now you write the answer to the question. Which is the favorite activities of girls? Which is the favorite activities of girls? Look at the girls in the girls column. Music, there are 12. Dance, 20. Reading, 9. Art and craft, 34. Which is the favorite activities of girls? Yes, 34. The column is art and craft. Now you write here art and craft. Okay. Art and craft. Here, art and craft. Art and craft. Next, which is the favorite activities of boys? Which is the favorite activities of boys? Look at in the music 6, in the dance 8, in the reading 11, in the art and craft 25, in the games 40. So which is the maximum in the number? Yes, the games. So now you write here in the second one question, what is the answer? Games. The favorite activities of boys is games. Okay. Shall we move the third one question? Which is the overall favorite activities of students? Which is the overall favorite activities of students? The total favorite activities of students is here 18, 28, 20, 56, which is the highest, which is the maximum in the number? Yes, 59. Look at, this is 59. That's column is art and craft. And the fourth one question, third one questions, art and craft. And then fourth one question, which activity is liked least by the boys? Which activity is liked least by the boys? Yes, that is the music. Now you write music spelling for the fourth one question. Then the last fifth one, who among boys and girls like the dance least? Boys and girls, who among boys and girls like the dance least? So here boys or girls, look at the dance column. Who is girls or boys? Yes, among boys and girls like the dance least, who is? That is boys. Who is boys? Yes. Here dear students, collection of data and presenting systematically is called table. Look at, it is called a table. This is called table. Collect the data and representing systematically, it is called as table. I hope you understand the concept of what is data handling. Dear students, once again, what is the meaning of data? Yes, data handling means, a data means any information. Data handling means sorting information according to what is available. And the data collection means, that is the processing of the preparing of collecting data and then grouping object and counting the object in each group. And then what is the table? Collection of data and representing is systematically, it is called table. Okay, thank you so much dear students. I hope you understand the concept of data handling. Thank you so much dear students.